We got to get the tranny story out before we move on here.
Not much of a story.
Well, I just want to know, you and Colin Quinn...
At his suggestion.
At his suggestion, went to see trannies...
Sing.
Guys dressed like women...
Yes.
Sing.
Yes.
Now, this sounds like the gayest night
out... I know
out
it does.
...that you could have with another man...
No, I've had gayer experience with a tranny, believe me. I've seen one hum.
What? Like, first of all, how did Colin approach you with this?
You want to go see some tranny sing?
Yeah. You want to go see a show?
I don't know. I figured it'd be fun. We'll go. Trannies, they sing. I don't know. You want to go? You do, you don't.
He had gone the week earlier.
Yeah.
And came to report that there was a fine show.
He went the week earlier, so he's going back.
Yes.
What's up with Colin Quinn? What's up with Colin?
And, I don't know. Occasionally I like a man.
What? So what did you guys see?
It was two trannies. And I have to tell you, I went. I figured it'd be a goof.
Of course.
They were really good.
Good what?
Singers.
Singing good?
They weren't hot, so I didn't have the whole, like, well, maybe if no one I knew was here, they were...
They weren't like those trannies that...
What were they singing that they were considered good?
We sat through, like, 1.5 shows.
Don't they sing, like...
Show tunes?
Liza Minnelli and all that crap?
No, they were really good. They had two of the best voices I've ever heard.
What do they sing?
This
is where you bury yourself. Go ahead. What do they sing, Jim?
I don't know most of the songs. I know one. I'll tell you. I don't know those.
They did a couple Ozzy songs.
They didn't do any Ozzy.
No?
The one did a version of Knights in White Satin, which was good.
All right.
And the other one, which I really loved the version, he did of... so hard to say. Did of Burning Ring of Fire by Johnny Cash. I really enjoyed
Burning
it.
Burning Ring of Fire.
I enjoyed
it. I'm sure there's another Burning Ring of Fire in his pants.
They got the Burning Ring.
The Burning Ring.
I enjoyed watching
Knights and White Satin. Ow. Never reaching my end. Ow. Letters are never meaning to sound.
They were delightful.
Delightful trannies singing popular songs of the days of yore.
Great, great voice. I really, there's a place called Bardo, and I don't know them. I'm not
Bardo.
Bardo. Uh-huh. Yep.
As in Bridget Bardo, one of the favorite actresses of the fags. Oh.
Is she?
Of course.
It's Barry.
Old,
it's
blonde.
Barry Bardo.
So you saw a show and a half? Or
we stayed because Colin had
why,
a friend.
Why would you?
He was an old friend.
Oh, a friend.
No, it was a female friend. Somebody I knew.
You sure?
A long time ago, he had talked to her. They were just going to hang. Yes, I'm positive.
Okay. I thought maybe, you know, tranny plays.
Yeah, but they had wanted to see it. So, yeah, I mean, then, you know.
Yeah.
It was uneventful.
A lot of, what was the audience like?
All gay men.
Right.
And me and Carl.
Did they do this one? Well, ABBA Dancing Queen?
No.
Very popular song now with Mamma Mia, such a big hit on Broadway.
They did not do this song.
Did you go see Mamma Mia on Broadway with Colin?
Certainly didn't.
That's a great show. They do ABBA.
You can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. Sit on my lap, Jimmy. I think it's a girl. Look at the closet queen. No?
I try to show my diverse entertainment interests. I get accused of just being an Aussie fanatic.
You
I am, but...
being with trannies isn't
sexual.
That odd.
You know what? You just out-gayed Ann and I.
Yeah.
What?
Well, there's things we admit to on this show that puts us in the gay zone, but you just, you out-gayed us with this one.
That's not gay. They're not gay.
I never knew Colin Quinn was gay.
He's not gay.
What?
He's not gay. Anybody
could be that. Two men go to the tranny club?
I know it doesn't look good on the surface.
It really doesn't.
But it was to enjoy. There was actually a couple of straight couples
Wait,
there.
We know you pretty well. What did he say to get you to go there?
Yeah.
You don't do anything.
It was more like he said, I saw this tranny singer who was great. And I'm like, oh, this is going to be hilarious. That's all he had to say to me. Any type of freak,
I saw this tranny singer. She's great. You want to go?
Yeah, man, sure. I'm easy.
You're a fag, too.
No.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, fag.
I got to tell you, it was really good.
I don't know. Fag.
It's probably a setup by all your friends. They got together and go, you know what? We need to know. Colin, make believe you really care about this tranny place and invite Jim and see if he goes for it.
There were two singers.
Yeah.
Joey Arias was one. I think that's the name.
Joey Arias?
And my particular favorite was Raven O.
You remember the names?
I certainly do.
Raven O? Raven is such a tranny name.
Yeah, I don't get it. Yeah. But.
Raven O.
They were really great singers. I got to,
Let's go to Trippy. All Trippy, right. What's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
I've been to that place. I was there about 5 years ago.
And
I had a great time.
Oh, cool.
It's no more gay than staring at mannequin man junk in Miami.
You know what? That's an excellent point, sir. Thank you very much.
Little gayer.
Yeah, but I mean, when I went there, it wasn't just all gay guys. They had lesbians there, and there were straight people. I mean, it was all a mix.
It was predominantly gay men, but there was a couple of straight couples, because they asked, are there any gay guys here? And they all went, ooh.
There was a good amount.
Did they say, are there any gay guys here?
How many gay? Yeah. They asked, what's the audience?
I thought maybe there was like a catchphrase. How many of the, you know. Did you raise your hand? Going, what's up?
Certainly didn't.
Let's just be goofy.
Dude,
silly.
You know how an ugly.
I'm going to raise two hands. Why am I sticking to the seat?
They're all good looking people, and I'm standing there in my Black Sabbath t-shirt, just standing out like a little straight white.
So you were upset that the men dressed like women weren't finding you attractive?
No. I just meant
what? No,
it's not what I'm saying.
I thought that's exactly what you said.
It's not what I'm saying at all. You really are a creep. That's not what I'm saying.
Okay. All right. It's just a couple of guys.
Did you get any movement?
In the front of my trousers? I didn't.
No?
No, I wasn't turned on.
Not attractive in the least, these trannies?
Let's go to Willie. Okay. Willie, what's up?
Hello.
Yo, that is the gayest show I've ever seen in my entire life. My girlfriend dragged me out to that thing. It is horrible.
Where was it?
Yo.
I did enjoy that show last night. We went to the other night back in 1991.
Yeah, back in 91 when it might have been relevant. Hayden, what's up?
Yo, what's up, man? I've been to the show.
Yeah.
Down at Bardo. And there's this one dude, Joey Arias, I think is his name. He looks like Fred Flintstone, but he does Billie Holiday. Amazing.
Billie Holiday. Every gay guy loves Billie Holiday.
I don't like Billie Holiday.
Like Billie Holiday, but it's amazing. You see this dude that looks like Fred Flintstone.
An exception to the rule, though.
The stuff was great.
Yeah, it was incredible.
But the guy looks like Fred Flintstone.
Pretty much in drag.
Fred Flintstone in drag.
Fred Flintstone with like his Spock eyebrows.
Bad Fred.
Hey, Fred, why don't you do me?
And they had a little band with them. Great little band, too. A little stand-up bass player and a little drummer and I guess guitar player.
Yeah.
A little area. Yeah, it's good.
Did you put your head on Colin's shoulder?
No, I didn't put my head on Colin's shoulder.
When they started singing love songs.
No, I didn't. It wasn't a close moment. We each had a seltzer. We chatted, and I'm like, wow, they're really good.
I'm a mini-breasted little nothing, Fred.
And I'm going to go back again. You will not discourage me.
You will go back again.
They were really good, man.
With your partner, Colin?
No, not with my partner, Colin.
You guys going to be adopting soon?
No, we're not adopting. I really don't like either of you. He happens to be a very good, straight friend of mine that just went to do something.
Fast forward 10 years, this crying Jimmy Norton by the bedside of an emaciated Colin Quinn.
Applying makeup to all of his bruises on his face and arms.
With their little adopted lad by
little
side.
Vietnamese boy bouncing, and I'm like, don't do that, daddy's sick.
Thank you, Jimmy, you know I love you.
Jimmy, who's gonna be daddy now?
did Colin get any?
The mommy in the relationship.
I realized that
get any at the end of the night?
No, we all went out to eat afterwards, and then I dropped Kyle off at the end. There was no sex.
You dropped him off in Colin's end?
No, I didn't drop it off in Colin's end.
Oh,
you dropped in the end?
My ears.
No, I didn't drop one off on Colin.
You barely hear.
I really wish he was here, because I could use the help.
It bugs me.
It was not a gay thing at all.
It sounds like a fun night out.
Yeah, it doesn't sound gay at all.
No.
No, I think that I would recommend you both go.
Oh. Together?
No, you have a girlfriend.
Just me and Opie?
You're both straight men. You can enjoy it.
I think we're going to go to a football game.
I would, too. I didn't give up the Yankees in football. Like, oh, no more for me, guys.
Right.
But I just happened to enjoy
you
that.
You want to see Jeter.
You sure did not.
You sure didn't give up on the Yankees.
It was a good show.
Sounds like fun. Yeah. Oh. Did they do this one for you?
They certainly did not do this.
No?
No.
This is a big hit.
And I'm going to request Burning Ring of Fire when I go back. That was my favorite moment.
The crying game. I thought it was a girl.
I had a feeling it was a judgment error to bring this up. Something told me
it's
the one you keep
under
your hat.
Yeah, probably you don't want to bring this one up.
Yeah.
All right.
I enjoyed it.
Hey, what's the harm? Two guys.
Men.
Go out.
Then Jim and Colin went to the tranny bar. And they saw guys dressed like girls singing great songs. The only reason they were there was because of the music and not the fact that they were guys dressed like girls. Oh, wah, wah, wah. Guys dressed like girls. His name was Bob, but he called himself Wendy. Oh, wah, wah, wah. Philadelphia, and he used to do the news on SNL, but now he's doing Jim Norton's A.
That's really hurtful.
Jimmy says he's not gay.
That's very mean-spirited.
It really is. I'm sorry. I apologize to Jimmy.
It was fun.
You finally decided to socialize, and this is what you do.
It was something different. I'm like, you know what? I'm too close-minded, and I went, and I just tell you, it would be more funny if I wanted to trash it, and it stunk, but I enjoyed it. I can't even trash it. It
took
fun.
One night to do something other than go around Manhattan and perform 20.
Oh, no, that was after my second show.
It was.
Yes.
Anyone hit on you there?
No one hit on me, dude. Women don't hit on me. Gay guys have a higher standard than they do. They're not hitting on me.
That's true. I'm awful. I don't get hit on by any of the gay guys.
That's why I have no homophobia or paranoia. Like, hey, just don't touch me. You ever see gay guys? They're all models.
Well,
there
was one Tree Fort episode, but you know, since then, not one gay guy's come on to me.
Yeah, you didn't have to start snoring during the performance, did you?
Hey, what do you say? Jim, you want to... Jim. You fall asleep during the show? You want me to suck your... Come on.
One day soon I'm gonna tell them.
He's asleep. Let me just... I'm gonna slip my hands down his pants and see if he wakes up. God, that's a nice fat. No, I was watching the show. I'm just watching the show. I'm not doing it.
Someone wants to know if the stools were upside down.
No, they weren't.
So they could fit more people in the club. Well, it's a popular show. You know how they like to squeeze more people in these places.
Did Colin push your stool in when you sat? No?
Someone wants to know if you went to the after party at the Ramrod.
No, I did not. We sat there. And I stood, actually.
All right.
And the couple in front of us, there was a couple, a guy-girl couple in front of us talking very loudly and being very rude.
Oh. you were bothered because you wanted to focus on the show?
It's a very, very small place. Probably just a little bit bigger than the studio in the green room.
So you say with everything going on, the girl is the thing that annoyed you the most? No?
That's what I heard, Ant. That's what I heard, yes. Now that I think about it.
Would it have been better if there were just no girls there?
No, it wouldn't have been better.
Okay.
You know what? It would have been better. Just a bunch of men enjoying some music.
Were they cramping your style, these women?
No, they weren't. Just a bunch of men.
Were they referred to as little bitches by anybody, no?
Ew, they have boobies. Seltzer and enjoyed the show. I'm going back.
Everything.
And I'm proud to say that.
All right.
We'll enjoy any form of entertainment.
Yeah.
Back when men were transvestites having other men do things to these men. I have me.
Wow, this gets...
Oh, jeez, I don't want to get the AIDS, fellas.
Anthony, yeah. This gets even better. Yes, Brett?
Hey, how you doing?
All right.
Hey, Jim Norton's coming to Lakewood, Ohio on October 26th, I believe it is.
Hold on. I believe tickets go on sale tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow at 10 a.m., yes.
Through Ticketmaster, yes.
Well, I just wanted to let Jim and everybody else know that Lakewood is the second gayest population, second only to San Francisco.
Oh!
Is it really?
So, is it a little gay area? Oh, I'm sure that's just another coincidence.
It is a coincidence. I did not know that.
Yes, it is. So you should be fitting right in there, looking like a lesbian and everything.
Woo! Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming to your stage, Jim Norton.
Jim Norton. Yeah!
Dressed up like Dolly Parton. You thought you were seeing a comedy show.
Well, that's right. Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the stage right now. You might recognize him from the Opie and Anthony show out of New York. It's Jimmy Norton. Let's give a big hand for Jimmy Norton. Jimmy Norton, former Tampa Bay cheerleader. She's got all the moves. Let her hear it. Let her hear it, people. Make sure to tip the dancers. They're doing this for you guys. Look at Jimmy go. Come on. Second dance, Jimmy takes his shorts off and he really lets it all hang out. When you short on your... Look at, there's Colin Quinn joining him on stage. Colin Quinn, you might remember him from SNL. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm using Jim Norton's real name. Let's use his stage name. Make way for Soupy Drek. Soupy Drek taking the stage. What a beautiful set of cans on Soupy Drek. Yeah, dance it out, guys. There they go. Look at all these men coming over and handing the money. Isn't this great? Here in the gayest area of Cleveland.
You know I love you, Jimmy.
Yeah, I really asked for it this time. I deserve this. Dummy I am. I never should have agreed to go to that.
And you said there was not much to this story.
I didn't think there was. I figured you guys would go, trannies, huh? And then move right on.
Only 40 minutes of good radio.
I forgot the improv skills.
Did Colin at some point go, I miss Kenoba? There was no crying about other men?
There was
no
crying about other men. Yeah. We stood there and we had our seltzers and laughed.
A little seltzer.
Right. And had that's dinner good. After in okay. a French restaurant.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. That's
a little French went on.
That'll help you get to back to the man zone.
It was very good food.
Sake.
Right.
That's good. All right. Well, there it is. Their little night.
It was a nice night.
It sounds like a lot of fun.
And
what's the harm?
Tuesday, and I don't know if I'm going this Tuesday, but I will go again.
You'll go again?
I certainly will.
Mm-hmm.
It's a short show. It's less than an hour.
Oh.
Show, which I like.
That's quick?
Yeah, it's 45 minutes. There's like four or five songs, and that's the show.
You and Colin, in, out, done, right?
Yeah.
Fast. That's good.
You in, good. Go out.
Yeah. Did they hold hands during Knights in White Satin?
No, we didn't hold hands.
No, from Maryland. Don't be silly. Of course they didn't hold hands.
They were too busy making out.
That would be gay.
We weren't making out. We just stood there and we talked a little. Just
a little chat?
Did you
compliment the singers to each other? Like, did you lean over and go, jeepers, Colin, thanks for taking me. Boy, he really can belt it out.
Hey, Joe from Philly wants to know if Jim is changing the website from eatabullet.com to eataseed.com.
No, I'm not changing the website at all.
Well, Hung wants to know how many Shirley Temples did Jim pound back to loosen up.
And
Pyro from Toronto, lay off Jimmy. He's not gay. He's just desperate.
I shook the hand of one of the singers, Joey Arias, and I said it was a great show. And
said,
thank you very much.
You got to meet to. Were you and Colin by the backstage door?
No, there's no backstage.
Oh,
it's a
no.
Small little bar area. And the other, Raven-O, I actually wanted to meet and say great show, but I did not.
Oh, did you get a picture with either of them?
They're not famous. No, I did not get a picture.
I thought maybe you'd put that up on your website.
I certainly wouldn't.
That would be kind of cool. Now, it would be kind of cool to see. In hindsight.
Yeah, well, that's the funny little things you think of later. These little things.
Frenchie.
Hey, what's up, guys?
What's up?
I was vacation, huh?
It was great. All right, Frenchie.
Jim Norton, you're a faggot, man.
I'm not a faggot.
Were you wearing a skirt that night, too?
No, I wasn't wearing a skirt.
Transvestite.
What?
Transvestite.
Oh. No, we enjoyed our vacation, and I wasn't wearing a skirt, you stroke victim. I enjoyed the show with my friend
like
Colin.
It would go down your leg all the way down to your feet, you whore. Huh? You faggot. Suck it, you faggot. That's what probably he said to the waiters over there, huh? How about you suck my C, you faggot?
Suce-moi.
Yeah, exactly. Suce-moi, poufias.
Listen, I am not gay. I'm not. I just enjoyed the show.
You just enjoyed the guys. That's it, right?
Yeah.
Why do you feel like you have to defend yourself?
No, yeah. I'm.
We were just asking questions.
I'm only saying I just enjoyed the show, and now Frenchie is calling, and maybe I'll give his restaurant a plug and give out the location.
No, you're not. You faggot. You all about 10,000 people in the front of the window throwing rocks at it. You faggot. Die. All right, I take it back, you faggot.
All right, Frenchie.
All right, guys, take it easy.
Frenchie, we don't want to burn you out.
No
so.
Problem, bye. Right, bye.
That's the nude photo threat.
Yeah,
I'll put them on the internet.
That's it. Put them right on the internet, you bastard. Chris from Long Island says that he saw Colin cutting out the bottom of his popcorn container and then putting it in his lap and having you eat popcorn out of it. Was there popcorn available there?
There was no popcorn
All right,
available.
Then he's obviously lying.
I don't know about that because we have audio of Colin Quinn when Jim Norton was reaching into the popcorn thing there.
Oh, you like that, don't you, faggot?
Is this anybody you know?
No, it certainly isn't.
All right, I'm just some gay gentleman on the website.
I resent these implications.
All right. Did they have hot chowder down there?
No, they didn't. It was a bar atmosphere. There was no food available to anybody.
How many Cosmos are just flying off the bar? I bet a lot. Cosmo, Cosmo, Cosmo.
Yeah. All right.
It sounds fun.
Sounds interesting, sure.
Yes, it was a good time.
All right.
Not as much fun as people will have tomorrow at the Count Basie Theater, but
in
Red Bank?
Yeah, it's almost.
Okay.
Very good.
Yes.
Very good.
Sex in the City, yeah, we'll talk about that news.
Yeah.
And no, I know. And Charlton Heston with the Alzheimer's Anthony. And Sex for Sam 3.
I was in a gay club, but I forgot. Me and Colin went. It was great. Men dressed as women dancing. It's fabulous. I wish I could remember it. Oops, I just forgot what I was talking about.
If you're gay and you forget, then you did
it
anything?
Doesn't make you gay. No, then you're not gay anymore.
You're not gay?
I've been sucking C all over the place, and then I just plumb forget. Till I burp and a big white bubble comes out. Bloop, what do I don't remember having salty yogurt? But I don't remember anything. Bloop, oh, there goes another one. It's floating away. Hey, Colin, can I suck your...
Get out of this. We're going to get out of this. Moving on with the Opie and Anthony show. Lots going on today. Anthony wanted to talk about Sex in the City yesterday really fast. I didn't know you were checking out the Sex in the City.
No, I'm not.
I take a peek every once in a while. I'm not going to lie to you.
Dude, I have not watched one episode of Sex in the City.
You didn't see the stunt boob?
No.
When the one chick, the redheaded chick, was nursing her baby and they had the most amazing lactating boob?
That's disgusting. It's not sexy. And no, I haven't seen it.
Nice and full, blue veins.
Ugh. Nice. That isn't nice.
I got a thing for pregnant women.
Yeah, I know. We've been through that before.
You?
There's something sexy about it. Or they can be either repugnant or pretty hot, man. Yeah, no. There's something. No. Can I like the way that the certain area gets much darker and bigger?
Oh, God. No, stop it.
I like that.
No, I pregnant like women, not hot.
No, I disagree.
Not hot.
See, you're like a regular guy. You go for the straight thing, the hot chick and the sex. There's like fetishes and weird things and kinks in there that kind of turn you on. It doesn't mean the girl is, you know, smoking a Sports Illustrated model.
Let me tell you something.
But, you know, she bangs.
Dude, if you're into pregnant chicks, if you're a guy into pregnant chicks, you have issues. There are issues.
It's just a thing.
No, it's an issue thing. It's an
a mother thing.
I don't
Absolutely.
No.
Stop it. Yeah, but that fetishes are all, I believe, based on something that happened to you when you were younger.
I don't. The mother thing, that's weird.
I'm not saying, hold on. Because you know what? I don't want to deal with this. I really don't.
Yeah.
You should see the email that we get. It's a thing. It's not a huge thing. It's not like I'm going to walk out of here and get completely just over the top turned on. But some women that are pregnant or just gave birth and they, you know, they're nursing, there's a turn on there.
Yes. Pregnant women have, look, first of all, it ruins the women's breasts.
Yes.
It ruins their breasts. Number two, pregnant women have roids. They have roids. How hot is that? Hey, look who's here.
Wait. He felt like he had to come to defend himself. Oh, my God. He's got a statement.
Colin Quinn.
Colin, hold on, because we're in the middle of something.
Holy jeez, that's
hilarious.
Funny.
He has a statement and everything. He wrote something down.
He went to the tranny club with Norton.
Wait, can we get to the end of this discussion, though?
All right, okay.
I don't know they have the roids.
The area that is going to be used in the following months and whatnot to expel that child gets big.
Big and boggy.
And boggy.
Like a bog.
And kind of like falling.
Yes.
That's for her pleasure.
That is just, there's nothing about any of this. They get that water weight gain and the fat feet and no ankles.
That's the difference between you and I. You think too much into some things. I just take it for what it is. There's a kind of good looking woman and she's a little bit pregnant. It's a kind of a turn on. I don't know what it taps into, but it's like, hey, wow, cool.
It doesn't have to be mother, I don't believe. It could be that there are certain inappropriate things, like you're not supposed to feel about that.
Oh.
It doesn't have to be like, you know, I don't want to.
That could be it too, yes.
The inappropriateness of something can be sexy, like, oh my God, I can't believe I want that sexually.
Oof.
That's why I like certain things I like, man. It's not I don't want to bang my mom. I love her, but she's not hot.
No, I don't want to bang my mom.
I didn't say it's bang your mom. I said if you're attracted to pregnant women, there's a mother issue there.
My mom had a real nice set, though.
Did she?
Oh, yeah.
Mm. Oh,
she bent down to...
Oh, stop it.
She bent down to tie my younger brother's shoes when we were staying at the Kutchog Motel while our house was being redone in Centerport there. And she bent down to tie his shoe. I remember like it was yesterday. Nice set.
There's nothing worse than seeing your mom's boobs by accident.
It was there. You're going to look. I was young.
Nothing worse. I saw it.
I saw them on purpose.
Yes, Colin?
There's one thing worse. Living in Centerport.
Centerport's a fine little town. A lot of clamors.
Clamors?
A lot of good Catholic boys and girls.
You get to smell all the bunker fish when they get caught in the lake there.
That would be the mill pond area.
The mill pond.
It's the poor man's waiting room. River.
You know Waiting River? That's where my grandma's house was. Nice.
I watched my mother breastfeed my sister. She let me watch with my dad. You thought it was good for me to see, healthy? Yeah.
That's weird.
See, not weird.
What happened to me at the Kutchog Motel,
Oh, what happened to you at the Kutchog Motel?
I don't know. I didn't go out of my way to check this out. The opportunity.
That's creepier.
It just happened, though. What are you going to do?
Yeah, peeking.
She didn't know.
Yeah, what were you looking for?
Yeah. Oh, look.
What are you
going to
do, turn
something
away and make believe, you know, that nothing's going on there?
Yeah.
I remember this one.
Look, I saw my mom's boobs and I saw my dad's thing when we were at the zoo.
At the zoo? did you try to put peanuts in it to offend?
Oh, we went, you know, it was a father.
Is that how he got you to touch it? Here, kiss the elephant. Oh. The elephant's drooling. Is he sick?
He needs a kiss.
You guys are sick.
No,
the elephant's ears smell like onions.
Colin, You know, because you two are a bunch of asses. I'm going to go to Colin on this one, and I'll explain to Colin, okay? Because he'll give me the straight answer.
Uh-huh.
We're at the Bronx Zoo. I'm very young. Very young. Way before the puberty thing. Way before the three little chin hairs popped out. Oh, dear. Yes, oh, dear. And Pop goes, I got to go to the bathroom. I go, whoa, golly gee, so do I. And then I think another one of my brothers also had to go. Now, we're next to each other in the urinals. I'm thinking, you know, sneak preview for what I could expect in my adult life.
So you figure by looking at your father, you're going to know what you're going to be.
Because I was definitely at that age. I was definitely at the age, just before puberty, wondering, when is this thing going to start? You know what?
It's called bicurious.
What an ass you training, watching for. So I glanced over to see what I could look forward to.
Right.
Do you want to see how heavy it was going to get?
And there's nothing less homoerotic than a public bathroom in the Bronx, by the way.
Yeah, right. It was the Bronx Zoo.
Oh, gee, what's that going to taste like when I get older?
Yeah. I'm just curious, you know.
You're just curious. You're a kid. What do you know?
What's it feel like when some of it gets in your hair 20 minutes later?
So you snuck a peek.
So
yeah.
Ugh.
Just a peek.
My eye level, too.
Oh, yeah.
Did you sneak a peek when you tied your shoes? A good longing look? That's awful. At least I had a seltzer while watching that. I didn't do it in a urinal.
Hey, it's my
in
dad.
In the Bronx.
Dad.
So I'm in the bathroom in the Bronx looking at men's junk.
Exactly.
That's horrible.
This guy from the 62nd calls me.
It was just a quick peek. Like, okay, all right, that's what I could expect.
Yeah.
All right, fine.
I did the same thing with my father in a YMCA once. I did. I swear to God.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, of course.
See, you got to look. It's
psychologically
right
viable.
Nah.
He had a whopper, too. That was the only bad part.
A whopper. He had a whopper.
I said, Dad, are you sure you're Irish?
A whopper.
But my dad, man, no hands and like a foot and a half from the urinal. I'm like, what are you doing?
Oh, really?
Oh, he's one
showing
of
the, you.
Was he the Superman pose?
Oh, yeah.
The hands on the hips, the old man pose. Yep. My mom was taking the turkey out of the oven once on Thanksgiving back a while ago. And she had...
Dude, I have the best... you don't even have to... that's all you need to say.
Yeah.
I got the visual already.
But she had, like, her nightgown on from the night before. And she goes to turn with the turkey out of the oven because she's bent over, right? She's bent over. She picks the turkey up and turns toward the entrance to the kitchen where I'm coming from. All I see is this golden brown turkey, and right above it, my mom's cans right through the top.
Better known like, as dessert.
Ugh. It was just, it was a nightgown. So the
mom's
neckline. The neckline was really low, and with her bent over like that, it was just, two udders, just like, I don't need that.
Why'd you look? You wanted to just see what yours would be like someday?
Yeah, I'm catching up, too.
I certainly did.
Two long triangles. There she is. She turns around toward the door. I walk through, and what do I see? Her cans.
Thank you.
Freshly basted.
Your story is very similar to mine because I didn't know that that's what I was going to see at the Kutchock Motel.
Oh, at the motel. I thought you were talking about the Bronx
you
men's
knew in
room.
The Bronx what you were going to see.
Yeah, you looked for that junk in the Bronx men's room.
You actually did this, the little side look. You didn't accidentally stumble on that. You're like, all right, look.
Yep. Right. You looked.
Oh, I had to consciously think of looking, but I was...
And not getting caught?
Why
did you say, hey, Dad, let me look?
Pop, can
curious.
I see your hog? I'm kind of curious.
I'll have to
no,
ask
you me. Didn't. You made it a little sneaky thing.
I figured it was worth it to know
little
what...
sneaky
thing. A little sneaky Pete. And it went right in the Rolodex, didn't it?
that's a cute story.
All right, why don't we take another break here?
All right, then Colin's got...
a statement.
He has a statement?
I wrote feverishly on the cab over here.
You did? Okay.
You heard us in the cab?
What's that?
Yes.
I got the wire and then I made the cabbie put it on.
Well, Colin,
dropped a dime on this slanderous conversation.
Colin, slanderous. I was saying how you two sounded like you're having a good time. Colin's going to have a statement about going to see trainees with Jim Norton.
All right.
Well,
statement.
And I want to thank all Colin right. Quinn for the fine radio tease today because no one's turning their radio off
right
now. Thank you, Colin.
Ready or not.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Colin Quinn is in the studio. He ran down in the studio. I guess if you're just tuning in, Norton was giving us a cute little story about seeing a tranny thing, right?
They were tranny singers.
Yeah.
Transvestite singers, and Colin had seen them before and thought it would be fun to take Jimmy.
Yeah.
And you enjoyed yourself there.
Very, very much.
Sounded good. And for some reason, I don't know why, you were taking a ribbing about this whole thing. But and then Colin decided to show up. Well, I guess he heard some of that in the cab.
I think what he heard was Anthony pretty much calling him gay. And
I didn't say that.
Well, I do have a statement I'd like to make.
All right, Colin, your statement.
Over the course of his career and life, a man builds a reputation. If you will, a name. All he really has, what does a man have except his good name? That's what I've done in my years on MTV. I've kept any covert activities covert. Then to come in here today to hear my character besmirched as I sit next to a Pakistani driver who's giving me the fisheye, because even he knew when I told him to put it on, because of Jim Norton, a loose-lipped nincompoop, my whole career now reduced. No one will ever think of the happy laughs they had on remote control. They'll just think of me as the sodomite, boy hunter, degenerate. Thanks to the rumor and innuendo of this show.
Wow. I think you got a lawsuit.
I think I...
That sounded like really authentic.
Well, I don't think I have a lawsuit, because if we just leave it at what we know, I'll be fine.
Okay.
I don't want people to start uncovering old skeletons.
Really digging up the dirt. But it was fun. He said you guys had fun and it was entertaining.
Oh, it was great.
How'd you find the place?
How'd I find it?
Yeah, did somebody turn you on to it?
I stumbled upon it accidentally one night when...
The drugs must be really good at SNL. Time,
my girlfriend at the time, Fantasia.
yeah. Fantasia.
It was entertaining, but not as entertaining as the Rich Voss comedy tour. Have you heard about that?
Oh, my God.
Oh, he is a
one. Oh, no, yeah.
Well, Voss is trying to put together a comedy tour, yes.
Everyone now is involved with this. Everyone I know is somehow involved with
and
this.
Everyone's walking around very uncomfortably.
Yeah.
And embarrassed.
We're now, trying to avoid eye contact with Voss. Like, yeah, no, I'm sure it'll be good. It'll be good.
Because after last time we had that fun show with everybody making fun of Norton's dumb tape.
Yeah.
Then as we walk out, Voss gets chummy with me, even though we've been at odds for like 15 years in comedy. We only talk because we both have mutual friends in comedy. That's the only reason we even socialize.
So you pretty much have hated him for 15 years, but because there was a little repartee happening just before vacation a couple weeks ago, Voss now thinks you guys are chummy.
Exactly. Well, it's all because he wants to exploit whatever little credibility I have for his stupid tour, as well as exploit you guys and Norton.
So he's come to everybody with this idea.
Pop-eyed and salivating. Although I guess he'd be salivating anyway.
So he comes with this idea for this comedy tour he wants to do. Yeah. That involves you.
Yes.
Involves Jimmy.
No.
Who else does this involve?
No, there's a whole
Patrice.
There's a whole thing with Jimmy, too. He's explaining that his comedy tour won't interfere with Jim Norton's tour.
Oh, so now he's not stepping on anyone's toes.
I never thought it would. I don't think it. I don't
right.
He's got it all figured
That's
out.
That's even worse.
He showed me a contract with all sorts of stipulations.
He's been showing you contracts?
Oh, what?
Yeah. I don't know if it's a contract, but just some...
Have my secretary type this up. Daddy wants you to type this.
And I guess the tour would be... the tour's name would be the Comedians of O&A. Something that actually Ann and I want to do eventually.
Something
Girls
subtle.
Of Enron.
Yeah, exactly.
Something like that, yeah. And it would be featuring Rich Voss and Colin Quinn and...
possibly a Patrice O'Neill or whatever
Patrice.
He was available for.
But if it was something you guys would want to do, wouldn't you be the ones to bring it up and not certainly not Voss? Voss is
sure
broke and he's desperate. That's really what it is.
I'm sure it's all an even split.
No, even like begrudgingly goes, man. Maybe you'll get a little extra.
You know what? You guys are just plain creeps. You're plain, like, two-faced creeps. Colin,
yeah.
We booked two dates today. Are you still in?
I'm out.
You're lying.
I'm out.
Colin, you're in. Shut up.
I can book them myself,
stupid. Let me tell
you
something. You can't draw in your house by yourself, okay? You're through. You need us now. Shut up, okay?
Look at you. Right? When you say us, do you mean Opie Anthony and you?
No, listen.
You booked two dates already?
Huh?
You guys have booked a couple dates? What'd
you book, like the Tampa Improv?
No.
And the market the only show's not on it.
Only the markets are in on, dummy. No, we're going to follow a couple transvestite singers, then we go on after it. You probably know them, though.
Yeah, but we make sure we don't tell the transvestites what you're getting,
oh,
you creep.
Jesus.
I'm going to mention this. Hold on. Awful boss. He's a rotten man. He's doing something in Philadelphia, which would probably be...
He's not responsible for the Philly thing, right?
No.
YSP. YSP put another thing together featuring Voss that's beyond hilarious.
What is this one where you're doing with the band? You're hosting a show with the band,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'm hosting some show. I don't know. They just hired me to host some show. It's not a big deal.
And they're paying Voss, as they should, and they have...
He doesn't even know what it is,
to bring Voss on, they have Frenchie and the retarded Shirley.
Oh, no!
And this is what this coward says. Don't tell them what I'm getting.
Yeah.
You... creep.
Don't tell them what I'm getting.
That's something that, like, you know, Colin may say to another comic, like, you know, I don't want him to know what I'm getting, so he gets competitive.
Right.
You feel that way about Laverne and Shirley and
Frenchie.
I would tell them what I'm getting and show them the check and say, don't F up my intro, dummies.
You know what?
Awful.
He's standing out there last night in front of the cellar with his next, leaning on his broken Mercedes. The window doesn't work.
You washboard abs.
I heard you punched Ben because he tried to roll the window down.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
That doesn't work.
Oh. And
I got to take it to my mechanic. Daddy wants you to fix the window. Wait, what happened with the Mercedes that's busted?
The window doesn't work. What's the big deal?
Mercedes is old. That was the one Hitler took to the bunker.
Oh,
it's ancient.
Jesus. You know what? You guys are really crazy. Let's find as much garbage as we can on Voss on Friday.
Garbage? We sat in traffic for 40 minutes, you horrible Jew. You wouldn't put it in a lot. You're like, hey, there's parking here.
Look, it's stupid. You said put it in a lot a block away.
Rich, there's no parking. It's 9th Avenue and Lincoln Tunnel traffic. Where are we going to stop? At the tolls?
It was 8 o'clock.
Can I park here?
He's awful. And then we're like, we're stuck in traffic.
Oh.
He makes a left to go towards Broadway. We're going to 9th and 43rd. He makes a left to go down 7th. I'm like, what are you doing?
What are you talking about? 7th was clear.
You circumnavigated, went down Broadway, and then all the way back, and he wouldn't park the car. I'm like, dude, go to a lot. He's like, no, there's a spot up there. I'm like, there's not a spot, you idiot.
I found
it's
a spot
driveway.
Right. Hey, look, it's stupid. Did I find a spot right around the corner from the restaurant?
Yes,
right
you
around
did.
The corner.
Yes, you did.
All right.
40 minutes later, you did.
Now, was it my fault?
Do you know,
traffic?
We could have sat there until 10:30 p.m. and gotten plenty of spots.
Yeah.
It wasn't a matter of there will never be parking here again.
Blame the traffic, I mean, dummy.
Eventually, all the cars leave.
Of course.
And where's stupid Ben? Come on.
Ben's right here.
And then he tells the girl, come on, hang out with us. And then we drive, and then we get three blocks, and Ben goes, drop me off here, and leaves me with her.
She was a nice girl, though. I mean, she's an O&A fan from Holland.
Oh, that girl.
Yeah.
Oh, that makes her a nice girl.
I thought you were with her.
No. We all ate, but I had to leave. She's not, I don't date her.
Right.
She's a friend. We all ate, and then I went and did my shows, and she stayed at the bar.
You left a girl with Voss?
Why not?
What happened, Voss?
That really is true.
What happened with her?
I made out with her.
Did you?
No.
And then Voss, is it true you're getting recognized in the middle of Times Square there?
Oh, yeah.
By black guys.
Yeah, some of the brothers, you know.
It's nice. On their way to do a drive-by, they remember you from BET.
No.
They were thugs. These were not nice young college students. They were on their way to attack Bernhard Goetz, and they saw you.
Oh, what?
And they loved you.
Oh, yeah, you're a funny guy.
I wish
I could get a tan like that.
Oh, man.
Your old Mercedes. You hit the horn.
Man. Oh. Where's Colin?
He's right here.
Oh, he came into the studio.
He's having fun.
Well,
yeah.
He came in to defend himself about something else that happened.
About the tranny, the transgender community and me.
Oh.
I long and...
Please. You probably
history.
Came up to your car and you and Norton started singing to each other. What are you kidding? Shut up and... Shut up. Reshow cancellation. That's what NBC stands for. Not backing Collins. All right? Stupid.
Oh, that was really mean.
Yeah.
Exactly.
That's hilarious.
Hey, now I'm going to make fun of your stuff in your career, your highlights. Hey, what about that one-nighter in Morristown?
Yeah.
Hey, Vaughn, they didn't like
him. Stupid. At least when I book a gig, I don't find out how long it's going to take me to run home.
Boss, where are the two comedy tour dates?
We don't have any yet. We're just putting out some feelers.
I thought you said you had two dates.
We might have one.
Feelers.
I left a message for someone is not the same as booking a date. You just said we have two dates.
Well, I kind of lied.
I'm thinking of calling Angelina Jolie and asking her out. That means I slept with her, right?
Oh, yeah.
But not the feelers.
No, because she doesn't have a unit. First of all. All right. Stupid. Oh, God, I wish I was in studio for this fight.
When is your Philly gig, man?
I don't know. Next week they're doing. It's next Wednesday. It's at a bar called Chemistry. They're having like Octane play there.
Oh, cool.
Octane's cool.
And you know they're giving out whatever.
How much is Octane getting?
I don't. I know.
All right.
Now, well, anyhow, look at Dummy. You're still in. All right, and what's the big deal? I didn't come with a contract. I just came with a little proposal.
With a horrible, uncomfortable desperation.
No, it wasn't.
First to me, and then to Opie.
No.
You've been badgering us since...
Listen, you know what?
We walked out of the studio, and you're like... Suddenly, me and you were best chums. We had a rift many years ago. You were a road hack. And I was a respected insider in the Manhattan community.
The key word there is was, okay? Let me tell you something, you two-faced faggot. First of all, you know what's Colin said, I'll do a tour as long as I make more than Patrice. That's all you said. That was your That was your qualifications. As long as I make more than Patrice.
And he should make more than Patrice.
I was saying that to keep it light because I was in an uncomfortable spot. So I was like, let's goof on Patrice. Let's make a joke out of it. Because you put me in a weird, uncomfortable...
No, I didn't put you in a weird...
sweating energy with your desperate attempt.
Shut up. Listen to me. You were doing research on other tours, what other comics are making.
Research.
Don't lie.
Research? Are you doing research?
Colin was.
You really think that you're a businessman now, don't you?
Yeah, he does. He's feelers and research.
No, I wasn't. He was.
Shut up.
All right. Stupid.
Did you have the proposal in a briefcase?
All right.
And did you try to open it, but your little hands couldn't move the buttons?
What did you hand Opie? What did you hand?
I didn't hand him.
Some kind of proposal thing, right?
Yeah. Well, you know.
And then outside the cellar, what did he say to you, Colin?
Oh, he said, Opie's fine with it. First of all, he wasn't even going to ask you guys about the tour. I was the one who brought up the normal thing. I was like, you know, maybe we should ask Opie and Anthony. You know,
first of all,
their names on it.
Dummy, you didn't say anything.
And then you had Rick Dorfman write up a proposal. One of his assistants wrote it up, and then you showed it to Opie, so hoping he'd read it to you, because you probably could only read half of it.
Oh, man.
The party of the first part. Who's that? It's on me.
You know, listen.
Then every gig, you're going to try and blow me out with your dirty act.
No, I'm not.
Patrice.
And no, I'm not.
Colin, we got to switch, you know. You're great, but and then you're going to slander me behind my back to all the Jersey one-nighter guys.
Oh,
I can see it all now.
Shut up.
Here's Voss talking to Colin, first night of the tour.
He was banging cocktail waitresses two at a time.
Oh, angry.
Oh, man.
And a man in my position can't afford to be made to look ridiculous.
You hear that, boss?
You're trying to book yourself high-profile MC gigs. This really bugs me.
You know what, dummy? Shut up. You're on my side, so don't turn on me now.
I'm not turning on you at all.
All right, you said it's a good idea, all right? You also
he didn't know what else to say. It was a polite thing to say to a friend.
Oh,
Norton
please.
Pities us all that
What's
we can't
that?
Even. That he had, and you had the nerve to say we won't interfere with your gig. He knows that, stupid.
You're right.
We'll be working theaters and we'll be working funny bones.
Hey, you know what?
Jim, if this in any way gets in the way of you, we won't do it.
Oh,
Jim's just sitting there pitying us all, stupid.
Oh, you know what? You know, you're just like, you're like a broad.
Oh,
you know, you're still doing it. You're not backing out.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
I quit.
You're not quitting before it starts. You're still in, dummy.
We're going to sponsor the Colin Quinn tour.
Oh. Yeah.
You know how fast these three personalities would clash, Boss, Patrice, and Colin? It would be
Are you
kidding me? That it would be great. It would be great shows, and it's going to work, all right?
You're shows still would be great, yes. I'm talking about behind
Someone
the
wants
scenes.
To know if the tour is going to be called the O&A Midget Jew Comedy Tour.
Come on, folks. Give him a hand, but only a little one.
Rich, the caller on the phone, not Rich Voss. What's up?
Hey, listening to Voss speak, it sounds like surgery. Sucking here. You just want to get all that spit out of his mouth.
Shut up, stupid, and go back to work.
Yeah, Voss, want to talk. You're on the phone.
All right. Shut up. Make your delivery and go home.
Hey, Voss.
Make your delivery.
Voss, I just like you are, I'm self-employed, you prick.
Oh, everybody's self-employed.
Yeah, I'm a personal trainer chef, you dumb little midget Jew.
I'm a personal trainer. Where, at Bally's?
No, for myself. Thank you very much, Voss. At least I can get my hands around the weights.
Probably.
You know, we give you the 3-pound dumbbells because that's the only thing you get your fingers wrapped around.
Yeah, I can get it. I can get around
inside your gherkin.
I can get around your girlfriend's breast too.
Yeah. All you right. Get it around the nipple. That's all you would.
All right. I'm tired of flossing whenever I'm with her.
Voss,
ramp.
Voss, when you get up off the step stool, then you can talk to her.
Yeah, that was funny.
All right.
You're done. Go back.
Voss said breasts because he's trying to show me how he can work clean.
All right, Voss, get out of here, man.
All right, I'll see you guys.
See you, Rich.
Good luck with this comedy tour. We look forward to hearing the...
All right.
Next time you see me, seriously, don't talk to me. Go through my agent from now on.
No more personal contact.
You know what, Colin?
I'll let Manny toss you if you go near me at the cellar.
Colin.
I'll get a restraining order from Manny.
Colin.
Yes, Richard.
Yeah, there he goes.
Whoa.
Three attempts.
Colin.
Hilarious.
I'll get him.
Colin.
Right. Oh, that's like a weight off my back right now.
Is it?
That we've outed Voss.
Was that just been bugging you?
Oh, it's just been uncomfortable, you know? It's really weird.
And I actually think
it's a needy look.
It would be a great tour, but I know what's going to happen when I see him now. He's going to go, what? They said it was okay.
They said it was okay. Everyone's being two-faced.
Two-faced. He called Colin two-faced.
Two-faced
bastard.
He sounds like the Bowery Boys.
You're not two-faced. Oh. Not a T and a D in there.
I'm shelf-employed.
Yeah.
Let's get some sushi.
Wow, man.
Don't tell them what I'm getting. I almost strangled him for that. What's wrong with you?
A French cook and two retards.
And two retards.
Don't let them on.
These aren't power brokers in the industry. They're just nobodies who are bringing you up for the fun of it.
Mom's the word.
Mom's the word. Oh, man.
Keep this on the cutie.
That soupy dreck.
Oh, God.
And he said he was taking a nap, and he just woke up. That means one of his daughters had to, like, shake him. Daddy, there's bad mouthing you on O&A.
I'll get Daddy the phone. Dial the number. Go grab Daddy the phone. What did they say? Are they being two-faced?
Two-faced.
Two-faced.
Is he also light-skinned, you ass?
All right, Daddy's going to be on the phone a while. Fix yourself a lean cuisine and a tortilla.
Tortillas.
Tortillas.
He was alive when Kennedy was shot and he pronounced silent L's. You know how disturbing that is?
Okay.
Friday!
And you're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. In studio, Colin Quinn.
Yes.
He stopped by to defend his honor.
And he did a good job.
Read a statement. And then we had Rich Voss on the phone. What a lot of fun that is when Rich calls in.
Rumor has it the retarded Laverne and Shirley are stopping by today.
For
that poses a problem because Lady Di has been banned from this radio show.
Right.
Also, we got a letter from Stalker Patty.
Oh, yeah.
Another person that has been banned from this radio show.
In her crazy person handwriting.
But she writes letters to keep us all updated on what she's been up to.
She's written a whole letter about how she has a new place to live, finally. She's been homeless since, I believe, we got her thrown out of her place. Then when we got her thrown out of her place, it seems like just yesterday. To her, it seems like it's been about 10 years
well, yeah.
of living in shelters and being raped and robbed and everything else that could happen.
It was our version of let's make a deal. And it just it didn't turn out okay for her.
Yeah. Well, we were just looking out for her. Remember when we said that? She was living in a house, and she was living with people that really didn't like Patty being there. It's almost like a Colin Voss relationship, you know? They just avoid each other, but it's the status quo until someone pulls a bonehead move.
Right.
Then the gloves come off. Well, we thought the family wasn't treating Patty very well. And apparently the family did not like Patty. They wanted her out. And we made a phone call to the family to stick up for Patty, and they said, you know something? Fine. Get her out. And she was out on the street. And that was quite a while ago.
And then we proceeded to rip the wig off her head and kicked her off the show.
We tried to hook her up in an apartment, and we wound up hooking her up with a guy that confessed to double murder.
Oh, yeah.
Remember that one?
Eddie the murderer.
Eddie the murderer.
I forgot about that.
That made the newspapers and the evening news. And
we were interviewing the guy to make sure it was okay for Patty to live with this guy. And we were okay with it.
We were fine with it. We were just talking to him about things. And then all of a sudden, during the course of this interview, to make sure he was safe for Patty to live with, he confessed to a double murder, a dismantling of the bodies of a couple of Colombian drug dealers. So that didn't work out too well for her. And she finally now has a place. She sent a little, I've moved, a little card that says, I've moved. Patty. She's old address. Various people's couches. My suite under the stairs, because she was living here at the station under the stairs in the lobby. And various New York City shelters. And now she's on 43rd Street in Midtown Manhattan. How does she get a place?
43rd and what?
I'm not going to give the number, but...
God forbid a stalker stalks a stalker.
Yeah.
You could look at the address there and see where... How is she living there?
Not far from me.
Hi, Jimmy.
She's funny, she's in my building.
So she's written us. Welcome back from your fake suspension.
We're on vacation.
Yeah. I'm now setting up house in my humble abode of 1 week, and I'm so grateful for a home at last. I have so many things not to look forward to anymore, like security checks. Worse than the airport, I actually get in trouble for bringing a bottle of Snapple iced tea in. A glass bottle, you know, as in weapon. In my naivety... A weapon is a gun, not a glass that can be broken, I guess. She's an idiot. Can we get some Hulk music for this?
Yeah, all right.
I had to pour the contents out in front of 3 security guards, and the bottle was confiscated. I felt like a criminal. I also know how an X-ray scanner works and... how to be searched, too. Oh, they probably searched her body cavity every night. I also will not be anticipating the 5 a.m. wake-up calls, the 10 p.m. bed checks, and can actually sleep through if I retire early. She talks like she's 80 years old.
I'm going to retire.
Like she sits in front of the fire with a brandy snifter in her mansion.
I think I'm going to retire, Jeeves. 1 minute to throw on my clothes because it was 10 p.m. and I had to be standing next to my bed for sign-in. I almost missed my bed check. Then you gotta...
Martini Steve, what are you doing? We're in the middle of reading Stalker Patty's letter. We're getting a Stalker Patty update.
I'm satisfying Ben's need to giggle, apparently.
What do you mean?
It's like I've got two interns and Big Kev walking into my studio going, Ben really needs you. Ben really needs you. I'm like, all right, give me 5 minutes. I'll be right in.
Just so Steve Martini can walk in the studio.
Exactly. Just so Ben can sit and laugh right there.
Martini Steve,
while O plays the music.
Well, the music follows you now.
I know.
And you got the smoking jacket on still. Don't you have work to do?
I'm trying.
The ascot's a nice touch, too. With the ascot, the martini, the cigarette holder.
You can retire.
Yeah, you can retire by the few. You're really not needed right now in the studio, Steve. All right, there he goes.
There he goes.
Yeah.
Martini Steve. And Ben just freaking has a conniption. He loves it so much.
Colin, that's his new name, Martini Steve.
I love his theme music, too.
He loves the martini.
Well, the music follows him. It's a pain in the ass.
Anywhere he goes.
We're not getting any work done in the back office when he walks in and out. The whole band follows him for some reason. All right, back to Stalker Patty's letter.
Yeah.
A Stalker Patty update.
She has moved
to the Times Square area.
Yeah.
Okay.
No more curfews, which means if I work late or want to do something, it's a mammoth problem. One lady wanted to see her parents in the hospital, and she had to get a note from the hospital first, even though it was an emergency. She had to choose between her father and her bed. The curfew prevails.
What?
There's a curfew at the old... This is
the old place.
Yeah, the old place. She goes... she had to throw her clothes on and get to her bed by 10 p.m. and stand next to it for bed check. She goes, I almost missed the bed check. Then you gotta lug all your stuff downstairs and wait for another bed to come up, as once your bed is vacant, another person will be there in the blink of an eye.
Is this Full Metal Jacket?
I know.
Private Ant Body! You disgusting skinny bitch! A Snapple bottle in your footlocker! What do you call that Snapple bottle?
Charlene.
It's the weapon, she said so.
That's right. I got the tie in.
Well, all that is over now. Last night, I rediscovered the joy of cooking and made shrimp scampi over linguine from scratch. Ugh. I have my bathroom done with a touch of the sea.
What?
Who talks like that?
What?
Because I had my bathroom done with a touch of the sea.
Oh, sea. Okay.
Since she looks like olive oil.
The dolphin shower curtain and fish decals on my wall. Like a retard.
And the rotting anchovy smell.
In 2 weeks, I'll put a fishbowl in there with some Tetris for effect. Well, have a happy. Thank you for your support.
Support? We got her thrown out.
We humiliate her, got her thrown out of her place.
I love you all, Patty.
There you go. That's a Stalker Patty update.
Little update of somebody that is no longer on the show, but people have been curious as to what she's been doing. She's got a new place. And it's in Times Square.
She's getting her life together. She's now cooking a little bit.
Shrimp scampi.
Opie, I commute. I commute every day from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Because I really, can't afford
it. Manhattan's kind of pricey.
Don't tell her how much I'm making.
But Patty now
is in the heart of it all.
Has a place in Midtown Manhattan.
Midtown.
She's in Midtown. She's in the heart of the pinnacle of the free world.
Maybe she's turning tricks.
And I'm driving in from Brooklyn every day on that goddamn Gowanus.
Someone is saying, hold on.
Yeah.
Hey, Vinny.
Hello?
Don't give away the exact address, but you're saying where Stalker Patty lives is a shelter run by Ben and Jerry's?
Yeah. I will bet the ranch that that's where the place is. They run, they own a whole building in Times Square, and the Ben and Jerry's is on the main floor, and they own the whole building, and it's a monster homeless shelter. My sister used to work at the Ben and Jerry's. And she would tell these horror stories of homeless people coming in and getting the wrong door.
Really? And is it nice?
I don't know. I haven't lived there. The Ben & Jerry's is nice.
Let me see if I can pop that up somewhere.
All right.
The ice cream's good, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I figure they make... You know what it is? These two, you know, they're such liberal wimps. They figure, oh, we've made too much money. We have to help the world. So they give away 2% of all their ice cream to stop nuclear war.
Right, and save the whales.
Ben and Jerry, can I give more? Yeah.
I mean, the woman is... First off, she gets thrown off your show. Now she's living Midtown. She's right above an ice cream store. She's a block away from WWF New York. Is life fair?
All right, Vinny, thank you.
They have a new flavor at Ben & Jerry's, you know?
Yeah.
Stalker Patty's Pap Smear.
Good stuff.
Swirl.
Homeless hiss. Here we go today, some homeless hiss.
Kevin, what do you got for the show?
Hi.
Hi, Kevin. What's up?
What's up?
Who are you?
Who am I? My name is Kevin Avianz. They said you were doing a story about me today.
We were doing a story about you?
Yeah, he said I was performing last night. I wasn't performing last night. You know, someone went to Bardell and saw maybe my friend, Raven.
Oh, Joey, two nights ago. Tuesday.
Tuesday night.
Joey Diaria.
Wait, are you one of the trainees that these guys saw?
Actually, I'm not one of the trainees that they saw, but they kept saying it was my name. And I was like, what are you talking about?
No, it was Joey Diaria.
You didn't say your name. It was Joey,
Joey Arias.
Yes.
One of my, I look up to her. She's amazing.
Yes, so do we.
Totally amazing.
And who's Raven O?
Raven O is another jazz performer. And more androgynous, though. Not so much a full-on, how can I say, transgendered person.
Right, yeah, I didn't think so.
Yeah.
So
she looks more muscular. Well, you have to go to my website, kevinavianz.com, and see it. So
wow.
You have to see the pictures. So.
And do you perform at this club?
Yeah, I have performed there once, but I'm traveling all over the world right now, doing my tour right now. So
need an opening comedian? There's a guy, Rich Voss, who's looking for people.
Excuse me?
Nothing. Inside thing. Well, that's great, and you dance, and you're training.
I dance, I sing. I recently have a number one single called Alive around the country.
Oh. All right. Well, we're trying to hunt down the trainees that these guys saw the other night.
Well, they're not. You don't call them trainees, okay? These people are professionals. They're performers. So when you call them the trainees are somebody that, you know, that have problems, that are, like, going to have a change. These people don't have changes in their lives. They are who they are. Well, so you can't call them that, you know?
But you can't call anyone anything anymore.
Just be careful with those girls.
Do you have but you have junk, right?
Huh?
You have junk, right?
Excuse me?
You have a mule, you have a member, you have a thing, you have...
The original parts. You have your original parts.
Do I have my original parts?
They're saying, yeah.
I'm a man.
Yeah.
I'm a black man.
All right, so you're a black...
6'2".
You're a black trainee.
No, I'm not a tranny.
Tranny.
I'm a man.
Hold on, they don't like that word here.
The T-word became...
Hold on. Let the delay build up. Basically, you don't talk and you don't wear the boobies. Then.
Boobies, yes.
Okay. So, all right.
But I don't need it.
Well, you dress up as a woman and you're not...
I don't dress up as a woman. I dress up as Kevin Avianz.
And what does Kevin Avianz dress like?
Kevin Avianz wears high heels. Kevin Avianz wears a lot of sequins. Kevin Avianz is amazing. Kevin Avianz is a person that's been doing this since he was 15 years old.
Now, you don't like quiz? Is that what you're saying?
Do you have a picture on the...
Wait. I'm a faggot. I was a faggot from 2 years old.
Hey, Tom. Stop.
What?
Yeah, we got this.
Excuse me.
I know. Hold on.
Excuse me, sir.
Hold on, Kevin. I'm sorry. We got
Tippy
Tom. We got Tippy Tom in the studio. And he's not happy with
He's a gay homeless guy.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, you don't like queers? Is that what you're saying?
Stop
it. This conversation ends right now. This is New York City. We don't tolerate any of this.
I'm a faggot. I was a faggot for 2 years old. Now, you don't like queers? Is that what you're saying? You don't die of AIDS.
Without us, honey, that
you don't die of AIDS.
Children, learn it, honey.
You don't die of AIDS.
You want to interview us, honey.
I'm a faggot. I was a faggot for 2 years old. You don't die of AIDS!
Aw, Tippy Tom ruined our little talk we were having.
With Kevin.
Kevin. Oh, man.
Kevin's gone?
Isn't that weird? Tippy Tom, gay guy.
And,
he wears
high heels and stuff, but he doesn't want to be known as a tranny.
He was outraged, except he still managed to get in 3 plugs for his
website.
I'm hanging up right now. Kevin,
I'm outraged.
He's going on tour. Him and Boss are going on tour together.
Hey, Rick, call him back. We got to smooth things over.
Yeah, we got to make sure.
We got off on the wrong foot there.
Tell him it's Tippy Tom.
It's Tippy Tom. Just say it's a guy. You know, everyone knows who Tippy Tom is. Explain Tippy Tom to him, and let's get him back on the air. And hopefully Tippy Tom will keep his mouth shut over there.
Yeah, Tom.
Now, you don't like queers? Is that what you're saying?
No, Tippy Tom. Of course not.
That's not what we were saying. I want to know what he wears and why he's not a tranny. I don't get it.
Because, Opie, there's a whole...
Well, the tranny name is bad now?
Yeah, there's a whole thing going on.
Why is everybody so sensitive?
Everyone's sensitive, and everyone thinks they're not what they are. Like, you don't want to be a tranny. Oh, I'm not a tranny. I'm just a guy that dresses up like a girl.
I never knew that tranny was a bad word for those people.
They won't allow high school teams to be named tranny anymore, either.
Really? Yeah. The trannies?
Yeah, they think it's derogatory.
Yeah, it could be. They might have a point there. Tranny. Yeah, because if you're a tranny, if you're dressing up like a girl, you don't want to be lumped in with all the people that are dressing like girls because you're original.
You don't tuck.
Right. So he says he don't tuck.
He doesn't tuck.
A little tuck of the schlong, and that makes
but
you a tranny.
But he still wears the high heels.
Wears a dress, high heels, dances, sings.
Well, transvestite is different than transsexual. They're different things.
Transsexual is...
Well, I believe transsexual is more of a medical thing. Where
that's after you've... Right.
I don't even... You have to be gay to be a transvestite? I don't know. A lot of them, I don't know if they're gay or not.
From the HBO shows I've seen,
they're lesbians.
They say no. They're lesbians. They go, no. You know, they show them all the time. It's like, well, I'm a grandfather. I have 5 grandchildren. Yeah. I'm a CEO of a major corporation. But on the weekends, I like dressing like a woman and going out to bars in New York. And they follow them around and... You know,
did you see the one on HBO, the transsexual who turns into a man and then dies of ovarian cancer?
Oh, what a kick in the ass by God there. Oh.
One of the sickest,
you think you'd have the ovaries taken out.
Documentaries on HBO. I think it was ovarian cancer.
Don't they take the ovaries out?
He's got a beard and everything.
Well, I got the ovarian cancer.
Dresses like a cowboy and stuff and...
Cowboy.
Oh,
they always grow the beards, right?
Grew the beard.
Does she have the big beard? Anytime a girl turns into a guy, they all grow that big. Look, I'm a man. I got the big beard. But there's no way they could attach a real schlong down there, huh?
No. Well, we're stalling because Rick's talking to Kevin. Let's see.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
I hope we can...
I just want to hear him talk to Tippy Tom some more.
Smooth things out. I wish I had more Tippy Tom clips. I only have a few. I got some dice ones.
See, that doesn't hurt me. That's like a nice thing for you to say.
See, maybe I could have dice talk.
This is why there's so many problems in the world.
Okay, yeah, we can do some dice.
What time is it?
It's 5:25 dice.
Well, why are you tongue-tied? Tommy!
I'm confused.
Tony Slanghini. What do I care?
By the way, this just in, Tippy Tom will be making an appearance on our show next weekend.
What time is it?
It's 5:25, I see.
Yeah, there were things going on. You got issues, sweetheart. Why aren't you talking now?
This could be all good. Right, hold on, here's Kevin. Kevin.
Yes?
Well, why are you hanging up and giving all those plugs and stuff?
Well, I'm not a person that can handle negativity.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to tolerate from you or anyone else or anybody that you work
Kevin,
with.
Kevin,
man, there were things
sorry,
going on.
Sir.
You got
I
issues,
mean, I
sweetheart.
Just don't. I don't have to deal with that.
Hey,
I'm
Kevin,
proud
Kevin,
of who
Kevin,
I am.
Kevin, Kevin, we understand. You know? We understand all that, but we're trying to understand why you got mad when we said that you're a tranny.
I'm not a tranny.
All right, so but we don't understand that. We don't understand because you were saying that you still wear the dresses. And
well,
the
first of all, I'm a human being, first of all. Let's start there first. Second of all, I'm a singer and dancer, and I have a recording contract, and I travel around the world doing what I do. And my costumes are part of my life. David Bowie does it. Grace Jones does it. Boy George does it. These people are my idols. That's what I want to be in my life.
So you do it as for entertainment purposes only?
No, I don't. I do it for a fetish and a entertainment, everything. I live for it. I live for what I do.
But when did the word tranny have a negative connotation?
Because I'm not a tranny.
No, I'm asking you. All right, we got over that. But what's wrong with someone being called that?
Because people that are trannies, that's another thing they're going through in their own lives. They want to be women. They don't have to be gay. They don't have to be straight. They don't have to be anything. They just want to be a woman.
Wait, what
is it? It's nothing about doing sexuality at all.
Oh, okay.
It's nothing about having sex with someone.
Oh, okay.
It's about they have something inside of them that they want to change.
I'm not afraid to say I like other men.
What, Andrew?
I'm not afraid to say I like other men.
There's nothing wrong with that, right?
No, not at all.
Kevin?
Yes?
That's male harassment.
No, it's not. Harassing them? Kevin, do you think we're harassing you?
No, we're not harassing him, but that person in the back is kind of ignorant. So.
I'm going to let it go.
No,
it's year 2002, honey, please.
I didn't do enough for you.
2002, darling.
You got me mad last week.
Huh? I got you mad last week? How, darling?
You filthy slob.
Hey, knock it off. Andrew, stop.
Come on.
Kevin, I apologize for that.
It's fine.
Do sexy.
It's
Come on.
Fine.
Do sexy. Come on. Yeah, but you got that ass.
Andrew, stop. Stop! It's not funny anymore.
Dylan.
Kevin,
so guys, did you check out the website? Did you see the website? Do you have a computer in front of you?
We're trying to get online, but it looks like everyone's checking out the website.
You got me mad last week.
Last week, you didn't even talk to Kevin last week.
I go right to your neck like an animal.
Listen, guys, thank you so much for this time.
I'm gonna let it go.
I have to get ready for a huge show. I'm on tour for the next 3 weeks. So.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Thank you guys so much
Goodbye.
For everything, okay?
Goodbye.
Are you performing in New York at all?
I am performing on the 22nd at XL on the 22nd of August. The 26th of August, the 2nd of 2nd of September. And then I'm doing the 24th for Junior Vasquez's birthday at Exit.
All right.
You see what I mean?
Are you at the Count Basie Theater at all?
No, not yet.
In New Jersey?
Okay. Hopefully.
So what? They're faggot. So what?
Hey.
They don't know how sick they is.
You know what really bothers me about you, sir, is that you have to call me faggot. Obviously, you know what a faggot is.
You see what I mean?
Darling, okay?
You see what I mean?
How dare you call me anything? You
if I ever see him, I'm going to punch him in the face.
What?
If I ever see him, I'm going to punch him in the face.
What?
Hey.
I doubt that, darling. I'm too big. Honey.
You got to talk sexy, baby. You got to put a certain tone in your voice. You know that.
Okay.
See, that doesn't hurt me. That's like a nice thing for you to say.
That's that
then. That's that then.
Thank you.
So what? They're faggots.
Bye-bye.
So what? They don't know how sick they is.
Kevin.
You gotta talk sexy, baby. You gotta put a certain tone in your voice. You know that.
Oh, you like that, don't you, faggot?
All right. Let's all calm down. All right. Got a little insight there in the whole... I don't know what that is.
Something tells me he doesn't listen to the program.
All right, that's okay.
Right?
I have to leave you guys. Can I plug my haircut at 6 o'clock?